Hello, I'm Edu from Edu for Java, and this is the second Android tutorial. We are going to talk about the main components in an Android application and the structure in an Android project. Okay, let's start with the main components in an Android application. The first component we are going to see is activities. Activity, we can think in analogy to a window. Activity is like a window, but you only have one activity in the top. It's a user interface component. You can have more than one activities loaded, but you have only one in the top. Let's talk about content providers. The content providers are is the way that one application, Android application, share data with other application. It's really encouraged by the Android system to share data between application, but these Android content providers let share data in a controlled fashion. Let control the data consistency. For example, to give an example, the contacts. There are a content provider about contacts in the Android operating system that let you or any application get inside the contact and ask for a contact or store a contact. But the content provider contact is going to check if the data you are trying to put in the content provider is consistent or not. Okay, let's talk about services. As services, is similar services in, for example, Windows services or a daemon in Unix. Basically, they have no user interface. You can connect to a services and get information and get disconnect to the service, and the service is still running. The service can check for events. For example, if you get an email, there is a service that get the event about the new email and can notify to the operating system or can notify to activities. Another example of services could be when you are hearing a radio and you are working in any application, but in the background you have a radio, then this is a service. It have no user interface, is giving you the sound, and the service remain running even when you close the console to handle the radio. Okay, I think with this is enough about services. Let's talk about intents. Intents are the operative system message. Is the way that the different components in Android communicate with each other. You can send an email, for example, from one activity to another activity. You can start another activity sending an intent, but really you send the intent to the operative system. The operative system is the one that is going to control if the intent is going to get or reach another activity. You can send an intent directly from one activity to another activity, or you can send intent, for example, generic intent. I can send an intent. Okay, I want to open this URL, and the operative system is going to choose or let to you choose which one application you are going to really open this URL. Okay, intents can carry data from one component to another. Yes, I think we are going to see more about intents in the future tutorials. Let's see what you can do in another application. You can store data in files, in the internal or in external memory, and you can store data using SQLittle that is incorporated in Android operating system. We are going to talk about SQLittle in our tutorial. Okay, network is really straightforward. It's like any Java. Is it like in any Java application? You just open a socket and start to send data. Multimedia is really well supported in Android operating system. You have access to a lot of code, a lot of depend on the device. You have a hardware codec, and you have access to the camera in order to get a video or photo. It's really good, the multimedia support. Global position system. It's easy, you can know where you are and have some access to maps services, mainly like Google Map. And at the end you have access to the phone services. Yeah, it's true, it's a phone. Your application can call to somebody, can send SMS and can receive SMS. Okay. We are going to see that in the future examples. Now we are going to see the project structure. Android manifest file is the most important file we talk about. Inside the Android manifest file, we are going to find a tag called application. Inside the application, we have here the activity tag. We talk about that we can find inside the application another kind of tag like services or data provider, content provider, sorry. And this activity have an intent filter. The intent filter here mark this activity as an entry point for the application. It's like the main method in a class, for example. Okay, this application, this activity, the name of this activity is .ventana. This means that there is a class Ventana in the default package. Here we have this, that extend activity. This activity has a method onCreate that we override here. The first line we call to his father, and then we call setContentView. That is a method in activity that fill the view. We put a parameter here, rLayoutMain, that is a resource identifier that point to a... Okay, let's talk about resources. Here we have res folder. And inside the REST folder, we are going to find all the resources in the application. Strings, icons, layouts. Okay, let's check. In values here, we can find string XML that we already saw. If you remember hello and app name, we talked about it in the last tutorial. And these resources always are referenced through identifiers. Main XML is the one that we use in Ventana.java. Is the XML that is going to have the definition of the window in this case. Here you can find tags representing components. This is a very fashionable today. There are a lot of user interfaces that are that are incorporating this XML description for user interfaces. In Android, you can use this XML descriptions, or you can use Java code, or a mix of both. Here we use XML. Okay, let's see. This is a linear layout component, and inside we have a component text view. This text view have a text reference to a string hello. Do you remember? If you remember, we saw it. Okay, everything in the rest folder is compiled in order to reduce its size by an SDK tool called AAPT that, if you are lucky, you are not going to see never. You are not going to see this tool because Eclipse plugin is going to make all the work for you. Then when you change a resource, you automatically get an error class updated with index constants that index each resource. As you can see, there is a constant for each resource in the REST folder. And if we go to Ventana and click in our layout main, we go directly to the constant main that have the index to this resource main XML. Okay, but what is the product of all this structure? What is the compilation of everything? The compilation is in a directory bin, but we can see the bin directory from Eclipse because Eclipse hides this directory from us. We can see this directory from the file system. As you can see, Android tutorial 1, inside the workspace, we see the directory bin. If we go to Android tutorial 1, you can see all directories, and there is one that is bin. This is normal from Eclipse. And inside com edu for Java Android tutorial 1, that is the package, we find the class files that is normal to any Java have this, but this class dex, this class.dex is the new one. This is a second compilation from the .class files. This second compilation is the one that Android virtual machine can run. The Android virtual machine is not a Java virtual machine. Okay, then classes.dex and resources are all packaged in APK file. All the final product of this project is Android tutorial 1 APK. This APK you can just copy to your phone and install it, and automatically you get the application. Eclipse plugin take this file and deploy in the phone emulator, and this is the way that we get in the phone emulator the application. Okay, this is all for today. I hope you see you in the next tutorial. See you.